if y'all could squeeze together a little bit, particularly, you know, if you have room to do a few, but if you don't mind, just we have a few more people coming in who would like to have a seat.
We got several over this way. Plenty of seats over here.
Sing a couple of songs of encouragement. We're going to sing the first and last stanzas, Leaning on the everlasting arms. I think we should stand. I really do. This is going to be a great, great sound. And it's 333. And we're going to sing and have just a good time in the Lord today. All right. Is everybody getting it? What a fellowship. What a joy divine. Leaning on the everlasting arms. Do you know it? Yeah, you did.
Lord, I pray this in Christ's name. Amen. my name is David Hale, and Angelia and I graduated from Antioch High School together. She wouldn't admit that. I met Dale in 2016 at our 40th high school reunion, so we're really old. And Dale, as we talked, oh no, well I'm getting old. But Dale, we talked, and he's talked in the music business, and I found that very interesting because I had some friends that were also in the music business, and I'm actually the worship leader at Grace Baptist Church in Mount Juliet here in Tennessee, about 35 miles from here. But I asked, he called me, well, I texted you on Facebook, or I messaged you on Facebook, and I asked him to let me know when the service was going to happen. He said, well, hey, would you like to come and sing the national anthem at the service? And I went, do you think that's appropriate? Well, I love the national anthem. I sing it a lot at Mission Barbecue and Veterans Day and a bunch of other places. But I told Dale, you won't believe this, but I can actually sing other songs. And I think it's important not only to remember Angelia and memorialize her, I think the most important thing is to honor and glorify the Lord Jesus Christ through this. That's the most important thing because He is the one that saved her from her sins and why she is now spending eternity with Him. And I don't want to break anybody's heart, guys, but she's not looking down on what we're doing today. She's a little bit too busy at the feet of Jesus. But it's a good thought. It's just... Well... I lost my mother and my sister to this cancer, and they're both with Jesus. And I came across an unknown author, and you guys have probably heard this before, What Cancer Cannot Do. So this man wrote this words down. It says, cancer is so limited, it cannot cripple love, it cannot shatter hope, it cannot corrode faith, it cannot destroy peace, it cannot kill friendship, it cannot suppress memories. It cannot silence courage, cannot invade the soul, cannot steal eternal life, it cannot tie the spirit. And it cannot lessen the power of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And God says it this way in His holy book, Romans 8:37-39. Yet in all these things we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. And this is where I'm supposed to pick this mic up. If Angelia could be here to share a song with you, because she is now with Jesus, I think this is what she would want you to know.
Someday I'll see my Lord face to face. 'cause my Redeemer is faithful and true. My Redeemer is faithful and true, and everything He has said He will do. And every morning His mercies are new. My Redeemer is faithful and true. He has proved His love for me. And when I lack the understanding, He gives more grace to me. My Redeemer is faithful and true. And everything He has said, He will do.
God gives us a mandate in His Word of what we're supposed to do at a time like this. The Scripture says in 2 Corinthians chapter 1, "Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion, the God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our troubles." Now listen to this. "So that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we ourselves have received from God." So Dale, Shanna, now, as we gather today, it's just our prayer that as we circle you with our love today, that there's a sense of God's presence and His comfort today in our inner life. And so, that's our prayer. As we come at this time, I mentioned a while ago that we do want to remember Angelia's dash. We're going to come at that time. I'm going to let Dale come now and lead us in this.
Morning, everybody. Dave, if you don't mind, you start us out. We've got a little change in schedule here. We're doing the old plug in, pray, and play thing. I have not much of a voice this morning, so bear with me. But while Dave's getting his guitar set up, I'll talk a little bit. Our life. Angelia, David said, she's at the feet of Jesus. I don't know if she's looking down on us or not right now. If she is, she's rolling her eyes, because as always, I'm late.